have to include, then we have to save this. So our next step is to right click on that project and click on scan all the file dependencies. It will include all these files into your project. Here you can see in the include, that is, it has included all these files. So our next step is whether we want to use that DSP BIOS operating system or not. If we in this case we are not going to use that DSP BIOS operating system, so we should know that which DSP kit, that DSP number we are going to use, that chip we have to, for that we have to go into the include option. Here we have to open DSK 6713, sorry, nowhere I have written 67, just sorry. So here we have to click on scan all file dependencies again. So we have to open that in the documents. We have to open DSK6713.h, as we are not going to use the DSP BIOS. So this is our step that we have to do. Here it's defined DSK6713. So our work is to define that chip. We have to write hash define. Okay. So chip underscore, what is our number? 6713. So we can define it maybe 0, 1, 2, 3, anything. So this is what we have to do. So we have to define that chip. And then after, so our all the work is over. So our next step is to write code. We can, for our simplicity, as we have to learn that kit, so we'll make just a simple LED blinking program. For that, you have to, you may know some of the pre-made functions that are in the libraries. You can see it here. These are some of the these are some of the library functions to initialize the kit. We have DSK6713 underscore in it for working with the LEDs. We have four functions. One is init, second one is toggle. If we want to toggle our LED, we have to just write a name. We have four LEDs on the kit, so we can write 0 or 1 or 2 or 3. So it will toggle that particular LED. To make that particular LED on, we have that another function DSK6713 underscore LED underscore on, and same is for off. So if we want to work with the DIP switches, so we have two functions. One is to initialize the DIP switches, and second is to get the values from that particular DIP switches. Same, we have the four switches, so we can use 0, 1, 2 or 3. To produce the delays, in our case we are going to use the LED blinking program, so we need some functions to produce delay. So here is a function DSK6713 underscore wait microsecond. So delay value can be any value, it may be 2 lakh, 1 lakh, depends, it's in the microseconds, so we can select our delay value. So now we'll write our program. We'll make the main program, void main. Here we'll firstly initialize our kit DSK6713 underscore. So we need it for many times, so we can copy this thing DSK6713 underscore init. Next is to initialize the LED, as we are going to use the LEDs. So now we'll simply use some while loop, while infinite loop. Here we can toggle that LED underscore toggle. We can toggle, suppose we are toggling the third one, just write a toggle. Then after micro, that is a wait microsecond, we can have a wait of 1 second. Okay, so now this is our function. So next step is to just save it and go on the sample project and build that project. So below is showing that there is no error. So our next step is to load that program into the kit. So for that, just connect that kit with this computer by simply pressing Alt C. So now click on File, click on Load Program, or you can use the shortcut Control L. Go into the project directory. So it's opening the project directory. Go into debug. In debug, just select that out file. It will burn that out file into your kit. So it is burning that out file. So it has burned that out file. So our next step is to run that kit, or we can run that kit by pressing F5, or we can see that our last LED is blinking. We can see it here in the video that this particular LED is blinking. This is the third one. Suppose if we'll change this in the toggle function, if we are changing it for, suppose as some another LED, we are changing it for LED 0. So change it for LED 0, then click on sample project, then build that project. It is building that project. So now we have to click on Control L to load that program. It's a shortcut. Select that sample project dot out file. Click on open. It will burn that code again. And again press F5 or click on debug and then after run. And see that first one LED is blinking. You can see it here that the first one is blinking. This is 0, 1, 2 and 3. So it depends upon our programming which particular LED we want to glow. So this was starting that how to make a new project without using DSP BIOS. Suppose we want to use DSP BIOS. So for that, all these steps are actually equal. So there is one step that we have to include in for making it for DSP BIOSes. Just click on DSK6713, where we have included our 6713 chip. So just remove that chip. Actually, we will select that chip by using DSP BIOS configuration. So just remove this. This is one thing. So we have to firstly just stop this running program. Shift F5, click on File, click on New, then click on DSP BIOS configuration. here we have to select our particular DSP kit, that DSK6713, and then after OK. So this is one thing we have to do, and when we'll press OK, it will show us a DSP configuration window. So in this window, we have to just to close this window for right now. We have to close this window. It will ask us to save it. So we'll press on yes, save it. We have to save it with some name. So in our case, it is saved in debug. So just if we can go back here, we can save it here with the name of it's a configuration one. We can give it a name like some name, or maybe just simply OS. So after giving it a name, click on save. So it has saved your configuration. Our next step is to add this configuration into the project. We have to does the same thing as we have done for header files and library files. We have to click on right click on the sample project, and we have to click on add files to the project, and we have to select that configuration file that is with the name OS for us. This is the file. So we have to click on open.